Summary Unit 4, Advanced Materials. Advanced materials are those materials whose properties have been optimized using technology. The content of the unit consists of four subunits. In the first two subunits, you will learn about advanced engineering wood products, their similarities and differences, their manufacturing process, uses, properties, and markets. The first subunit focuses on advanced engineered wood used as lumber replacement materials, such as laminated veneer lumber, parallel strand lumber, laminated strand lumber, oriented strand lumber, wood eye joists, and wood plastic composites. After going through the learning material, you will be more familiar with the raw materials used to manufacture different advanced engineered bio-based products and what specific processes are used to achieve advanced properties. You will also learn about the advantages of different engineered wood products. For example, the main advantage of using laminated veneer lumber is that the defects are not localized, but instead randomized through the billets and therefore improving the mechanical properties. Similarly, wood eye joists are lighter in weight, less variable between individual joists, and can be manufactured in longer spans using other engineered materials to result in a material with higher strength than similarly sized lumber. Somewhat different are wood plastic composites, which combine the wood with a thermoset or thermoplastic polymer and additives that, in turn, offer higher durability and lower maintenance than natural wood products. The focus of the second subunit will be mass timber building materials, specifically mass timber engineered wood products like glue laminated lumber or glulam, which is mainly used as replacement for large solid wooden beams, architectural detailing, rafters, columns, headers, and ridge beams, and laminated timber panels such as cross-laminated timber panels. CLTs are the most common mass timber panel system used in building construction. By the end of this subunit, you will know which product was used in the Norwegian Mosa Tower, the world's tallest timber building at the time of completion in February 2019. Another category of advanced materials is carbon-based materials. In nature, crystalline carbon is found in two forms, diamond and graphite. Subunit 3 will introduce you to the topic of the three allotropic forms of carbon, named graphenes, fullerenes, and carbon nanotubes, and the different methods which you can use to synthesize and produce them. Graphene, for example, is ideal for a variety of electronic and structural applications because of its electrical and mechanical properties, while fullerenes can be generated in gram quantities with a relatively simple apparatus. After finishing this subunit, you will not only be able to differentiate between single and multi-walled carbon nanotubes, or CNTs, but you will also be able to have a better understanding of how processes like chemical vapor deposition, exfoliation, electrochemical synthesis, arc discharge, and laser ablation take place and what are their drawbacks. The last subunit in this module will present the topic of renewable adhesives and resins. While composite materials can be engineered to achieve different properties by combining desirable traits of individual components, one of their desirable features is a durable bond capable of transferring load from one component to another. The use of adhesives is one of the most technologically challenging and expensive stages of composite production. In this subunit, we will focus on renewable adhesives or adhesives that are derived entirely or in part from renewable non-petroleum products. You will learn about several adhesion properties, including bonding mechanisms, adsorption, mechanical adhesion, diffusion, electrostatic theory, and wake boundary layer theory. Next, you will be introduced to two basic aspects that are to be considered during the selection of adhesive: surface preparation and penetration of adhesive. The last part of this module will list various types of renewable adhesives, such as saccharides, protein-based adhesives, phenolic acid, and more. For more information about the content, please don't hesitate to visit Bracket eLearning platform, apart from the website of the project and its social media. Also, you can contact any of the 7 partners of the consortium if you want more information about the project.